Good afternoon. Welcome to St. Michael the Archangel Catholic Church. Thank you for your presence with us. If you wish to make a donation to St. Michael the Archangel, we invite you to use the blue envelopes in the pews and place it in the collection basket. By doing this, it will ensure that your entire donation will remain with the parish. Alternatively, if you would like to help us with our Catholic faith appeal, you may use the yellow CFA envelope for your donation and drop it in the collection basket. As we prepare for the Mass, we would like everyone to please silence your cell phones. Today we celebrate the 20th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our presider today is our pastor, Father Michael Cannon. And now please join us in our opening hymn, number 714, Praise to the Lord the Almighty, number 714.
Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation. Oh, my soul, praise Him, for He is your health and salvation. All you compare now to His temple, draw near. Praise Him in glad adoration. Praise to the Lord, for all things is wondrously reigning. And as on wings of an eagle uplifting, sustaining, have you not seen all you have needed has been made by His gracious ordaining. Praise to the Lord who will prosper your work and defend you. Surely His goodness and mercy shall daily attend you. Wonder at how what the Almighty can do, who with His love does befriend you.
We continue in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of God the Father and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good afternoon, everyone. I too welcome everyone to church this afternoon. As always, I welcome those of you who are parishioners here at the parish. We welcome visitors joining us today. If there are members of other faith communities, other Christian denominations, you're very welcome. Thank you for sharing in this time of prayer with us. We also extend a welcome to those of you joining us remotely from across the nation and perhaps beyond our borders. It's wonderful having you with us once again today. And to prepare ourselves for the Mass, then, let's take a moment as we call to mind our sins, as we ask God for forgiveness, as we ask God for strength. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Cool. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen, amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
Let us pray. O God, who have prepared for those who love you good things which no eye can see, fill our hearts, we pray, with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things and above all things, we may attain your promises which surpass every human desire. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, observe what is right, do what is just, for my salvation is about to come, my revelation about to be revealed. The foreigners who join themselves to the Lord, ministering to him, loving the name of the Lord, and becoming his servants, all who keep the Sabbath free from profanation and hold to my covenant, them I will bring to my holy mountain and make joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and sacrifices will be acceptable on my altar, for my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let all the nations praise you.
reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I am speaking to you Gentiles, inasmuch as I am the apostle to the Gentiles, I glory in my ministry in order to make my race jealous and thus save some of them. For if their rejection is the reconciliation of the world, what will their acceptance be but life from the dead? For the gifts and the call of God are irrevocable, just as you once disobeyed God, but have now received mercy because of their disobedience. So they now have disobeyed in order that, by virtue of the mercy shown to you, they too may now receive mercy. For God delivered all to the disobedience, that he might have mercy upon all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus withdrew to the region of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a Canaanite woman of that district came and called out, "Have pity on me, Lord, son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But Jesus did not say a word in answer to her. Jesus' disciples came and asked him, "Send her away, for she keeps calling out after us." He said in reply, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But the woman came and did Jesus homage, saying, "Lord, help me." He said in reply, "It is not right to take the food of the children and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Please, Lord, for even the dogs eat the scraps that fall from the table of their masters." Then Jesus said to her in reply, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And the woman's daughter was healed from that hour. My friends, the Gospel of the Lord. In 1984, when AIDS was still a relatively unknown disease, a boy named Ryan White, who suffered from hemophilia, contracted the disease. He was 13 years old at the time. Because of a lack of understanding as to the cause of AIDS and how it could be passed on, Ryan was not permitted to attend school, and he was shunned by a fear-filled community. In an effort to protect his rights and secure his freedoms, his mother, Jeannie, became his advocate and remained vocal on his behalf until he died in 1990, at the age of 19. Fearless and tirelessly,
Ryan's mother allowed no one and nothing to deter her in defense of her son. She wanted our people to be united, not divided, in learning how to manage this dreaded disease. Another young mother came from Brazil. When she discovered that her 2-year-old son had a malformed heart and would die without surgery, she enlisted the aid of everyone she knew to try to raise the money needed to send her child to a heart specialist in England. Relatives and friends went from door to door, begging, and even stood on street corners asking for help. Even though the young mother herself was arrested for harassment, she continued, and in the end, she won the sympathy as well as the financial support that she needed to help her baby. These two mothers were not unlike the Canaanite woman from today's gospel story. Despite her seemingly overwhelming odds, she made her case before Jesus and received the healing she desired for her daughter. Her relentless love, coupled with an unshakable faith, impressed Jesus. Notice that she was not given a name in the story, but is often called an outsider. She was a Canaanite, we're told. That meant that she was considered an enemy to the Jews. That meant that she was different, different race, different culture, different religious beliefs. But she got to Jesus simply because she did not give up. Jesus, in this story, is giving us a very important message, a message much deeper than the healing of a child. It's a message about accepting and respecting others, not just those who look and act and believe as we do. As we look around our nation and our world, there are few themes currently more relevant to us. Jesus would see back then that his followers put a lot of focus on the differences between people. God looks and sees just one people, all whom God loves, whom God created, one family. God pays no attention to race or to creed or to gender or color or age or nationality, orientation, or any other human standard of worthiness or eligibility. God loves us, each of us, relentlessly and wants only the same from us, that we love God and that we love brothers and sisters. All three readings today carry that message. This relentless love of God is very well illustrated in our first reading from the prophet Isaiah. It's one of many visions with which Isaiah encourages his newly returned fellow Israelites from exile. But this was a strange vision to them because it referred to foreigners joining themselves to the Lord, ministering to the Lord. To hear the prophet say that God would accept the prayers and sacrifices of foreigners would have been shocking and totally unacceptable to many who heard those words. St. Paul, writing to the Romans in our second reading, also believed at one time that Christ's message was for the Jewish converts to Christianity, and they alone, no one else. But in time, Paul realized that God was sending him to minister to the Gentiles, the foreigners. He didn't like it at first, but when God insisted, Paul accepted. In today's reading, he even calls himself the apostle to the Gentiles or to the foreigners. Right now, as we look around our world, we see and experience so much division. We're seeing what focusing on difference brings. It brings hatred and violence, destruction, separation. There are no winners in this, because this is not of God. Today's scripture challenges us on where we stand on this subject. God sees and respects differences between his children, and he sees it as a good thing. And as I was preparing during the week, I asked myself the question to finish, am I someone who harbors dislike or contempt or even hatred towards people or individuals simply because they're of a different race or a different color or gender or orientation or nationality? And what about you? Do you harbor dislike or contempt or even hatred towards others because they're different? And finally, have we ever taken the time to see differences between people as a good thing, as a God thing?
Now let us stand to profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We place our trust in God, the one who hears our hearts and widens our capacity to welcome all as brothers and sisters, and so we pray.
You, O Lord, offer salvation to all peoples. Teach us to be a welcoming and loving community in praise of you. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You, O Lord, offer salvation to all peoples. Teach us the power of unity and help us to honor one another with respectful dialogue. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You, O Lord, offer salvation to all peoples. Teach us to be persistent in our prayers for the healing of all who are suffering, especially the people of Hawaii. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You, O Lord, offer salvation to all peoples. Continue to guide us and grant the success of our capital campaign and ministry center project. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, we pray for the gentle repose of our dear departed, especially Jerry Wiley and Jillian McDonald. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For James McCormick, Anita Graham, and Keith Schuddenboom, whom we are remembering in a special way in this Eucharist, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of the parish prayer line, the intentions in the parish prayer boxes, and for our own special intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Thank you, God of all peoples, for listening to the prayers we bring in faith today, and we ask to grant what we bring through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. And let's give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, For in goodness you created humankind, and when we were justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed us through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the
are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Frank, our local bishop, and all the ministers. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, remembering Jerry Wiley, Gillian MacDonald, James McCormick, Anita Graham, and Keyes Shuddenboon, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on each one of us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. Michael the Archangel, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we now dare to pray as one. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with each of you. Amen. And we offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. of Christ. The body 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 of Christ. Strengthen you. Thank you, Catherine. Beautiful. Thank you. Now, we have a practice here of offering a blessing to any little ones who have yet to receive First Holy Communion. I think we have one or two with us, do we? May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Who else? May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. May Almighty God bless you too, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, and the unborn baby. Amen. Any more with us today? Oh, do we have? Yeah, okay. Thanks for coming. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you. Are you Fiona's friend? Are you Fiona's friend? Wonderful. Thank you for being here. So now let us stand in prayer. Made partakers of Christ through these sacraments, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conformed to his image on earth, we may merit also to be his co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Just a few very brief announcements. We're still enrolling students, pre-K through 8th grade, and high school students who have not yet received the sacrament of confirmation. Enrollment for the coming school year for religious education. Details are in the bulletin, or you can contact the parish office. And our annual back-to-school pizza party is this Thursday, August 24th, starting at 5:30. It'll run till 7. It'll be under the portico, so join us for pizza, cookies, and drinks, and all families are welcome. And the summer Bible study series will continue Wednesday after 9 a.m. Mass. All are welcome. The study will focus on women in the Bible. Call the parish office if you wish to register. And also we've been informed that throughout the diocese here, a collection is to be taken up next weekend for the victims of the fires in Maui. So that'll be next weekend. What we will do is we will actually do a second collection next weekend for that. How many of you are visiting us this weekend? Okay, well, it's nice to have you with us, and thank you for sharing Saturday afternoon with us. It's always a pleasure and a joy for us to be able to host. So thank you for your thank you for your presence with us. And you're traveling tomorrow, aren't you? Travel, journey, and safety, you told me last week. So we hope your week was a wonderful one. Be safe. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Let's go in peace to love, to serve the Lord. Have a blessed week, everyone. Thank you.
And our closing hymn is number 869, Here I Am, Lord, number 869.
By the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry. All who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go. Lord, if you lead me. people Spain. I have wept for love of them. They turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send?